My name is Mike Blossberg.
And I'm JJ Plank.
Today we'll be looking at the new PASCO Wireless Light Sensor. Let's go ahead and open it up.
So as Mike takes that out, I just want to point out that similar to some of our other wireless sensors, this sensor uses a coin cell battery and low energy Bluetooth to connect to our software.
This sensor actually contains two different light detectors. On the back, we have our ambient sensor, and this can measure UVA, UVB, UV index, illuminance, irradiance, and photosynthetically active radiation, or PAR. On the front, we have our spot sensor, and this can measure red, green, blue, and white light intensity. Let's go ahead and power the sensor on and connect it to the software. I'll push the power button on the back of the sensor, and we'll notice the Bluetooth LED starts flashing red, indicating that it's ready to pair.
Okay, now that the sensor is ready to pair in our software, and we're using SparkView software, all we need to do is click on the Bluetooth icon at the top of the screen and then find the sensor in this available devices list. And it's easy for us to identify which sensor we're using because there's a 6-digit number written on the top of the sensor, and that 6-digit number matches the one that's shown here in our software. So I just click once to connect to the software, and go ahead and click done. And then on the home screen here, we'll be shown all of the measurements that sensor can make from both sensors.
For our first demo, we'll be looking at the UV index, which is found on the ambient sensor on the back.
Okay, so what I want to do is I want to set up a display that shows us the UV index measurement. And to do that, first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to shut off this spotlight sensor because we're not using it. And then I just find the UV index or the measurement that we want and then click on it here in the home screen. That automatically gives us a graph display. Now, we want to use a different type of data visualization. We want to go ahead and switch to a digits display. And to do that, all we do is just click on that right arrow and it takes us to the display we're looking for.
Indoors, we'll be using this UV LED flashlight as our light source, but you can also have students take the sensor outside and use the sun as their source. And you can even place the sensor into a logging mode to collect UV index data for a day-long experiment.
Okay, so before he turns the light on, I'm gonna go ahead and click the start button here. We'll start recording data.
So we'll look at our baseline here of about 0.5 units of UV index. And we can take something like eyeglasses or even various pieces of fabric to test their UV blocking capacity. As I place the glasses over here, we can see that it cuts the UV index down by about half. Let's go ahead and go back to the home screen and we'll do another experiment.
Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at some of the measurements that can be made by the spot sensor here on the front. Okay, just like we turned off the spot sensor before, I'm gonna turn off the ambient light sensor because we're not using it. Okay, what I wanna do is I want to use the sensor to measure red, green, and blue light intensity as we scan across this dark tabletop, white piece of paper, and red piece of paper, and we can see kind of how the intensity levels adjust. All right, and to do that, I'm going to go ahead and build a page here. We're going to put a graph display in there, and I'm going to add the blue, red, and green measurements to my graph display. And to do that, I just select them one at a time, so we'll go ahead and start with blue. I'm going to add another y-axis, add red, and then the last one, I'm going to add green. All right, so we've got our measurements in our graph display, and the one last thing I want to do before we start recording data is turn the sample rate up just a little bit. So let's go ahead and go to 10 hertz. Okay, so we're ready. I'm going to go ahead and click start. Mike's going to scan across, and I'm going to auto-scale our graph here. All right, and I'm going to go ahead and click stop. Okay, and as you can see here, we've got intensity measurements for all three colors, and at the beginning here across the dark surface you'll see that the intensity is about the same for all of them but nice and low, and then as he went up to the white light it jumped up in intensity on all three of them, and then when he scanned across the red paper you see here that the blue and the green intensities drop below the red, and that's because the way we see color is we actually see the light that's being reflected from the surface. All the other colors are being absorbed, so red paper we expect to see red light.
For more information on this and other wireless sensors, please visit pasco.com/wireless. Thanks for watching.